Hey guys, my name is Hamrozi and it is 17 August, which means that it's Indonesia Independence Day. And in this tutorial, I'll be showing you guys how to create feather design calendar using just simple shape and Inkscape. Let's get into it. So here we are, my friend, on the Inkscape interface. First of all, obviously we want to create a square by using the rectangle tool. So hold Ctrl plus Shift to lock the proportions. To have something like this, and then I'm gonna set the width as well as the height into 100 pixel, and then I'm gonna set it into black color, and then we'll go to the fill and stroke panel. I'm gonna turn the opacity into 50% like this, and then I'm gonna hold Control and drag up the mouse wheel to zoom in a bit like this, and then I'm gonna go to back to the rectangle tool. I'm gonna set the RX as well as the RY into 12.5, so it has something like this, the rounded corner. I'm back to the selection tool, and then I'm gonna add another rectangle like this, and this time I'm gonna make the corner sharp. I'm gonna set it into red color, and for the width and height I'm gonna set it 87.5, and then I'm gonna hold shift and click on the previous object. And then I'm gonna align it on the left edges as well as the top edges, so we have to position it like this. And then I'm gonna select this black object, Control plus D to duplicate it, go to the path, object to path to convert it into a path. And now I'm gonna go to the nodes tool, and then I'm gonna select every node that is on the right like this, and then I'm gonna hold Control and drag it to the right until it snaps. As you see, it doesn't snap because I don't turn on the snapping. And make sure you turn on the smooth nodes as well as the pads, which is underneath the nodes hierarchy like that, and then hold Control until it snaps like this, as well as on the bottom the same thing like that. And then I'm gonna select this object over here. As you see, the fill and stroke, it is unset. Hold Alt and click it again. As you see, the fill is gonna be red, and then I'm just gonna press delete on the keyboard to delete that. Alright, the next thing that we're gonna do right now is I'm gonna create another rectangle, and then I'm gonna create it like this, which is going across the small portion of the top of our, you know, previous object around like these positions. And I'm just gonna select this object over here, Control plus D. Hold shift and click on the red object that we've created before. Go to the path, intersections, so we have something like this. And then I'm gonna add like a slider, which is the circle in shape. So go to the create circles and ellipses tool. Hold Control plus shift to lock the proportion to create this, the, you know, something like this. Hold shift and click on the black color palette, and then I'm gonna press X on the color palette to get rid of the fill, and then I'm gonna make it the width into, you know, 3 pixels. Make sure the drop down here is on pixels, and then we're gonna step this thing aside to the right to the white canvas, and then I'm gonna go to bezier curve tool and I'm gonna snap it in the center of the object. To do that, make sure you, like, you know, on the bounding boxes hierarchy, make sure you turn on the center like this, and then I'm gonna make it like this. Hold Control and drag it vertically downward like this. Press Enter and back to its start point. Hold Control and drag it to the right like this. Left clicking it like this, and then I'm gonna select both of them. Go to the path, cut path, so we have something like a quarter circle like this. And that's what we want. And then make sure the cap is in butt and the joint is meter joint. And then I'm gonna position it over here. Make sure we have something like this. I'm gonna hold Control and drag it to the right. Control plus D to duplicate this thing like this. I'm gonna hold Control and drag it, you know, downward to zoom out to see if actually in correct position. I'm gonna turn off the snapping because it's getting in the way. Yeah, that's a perfect position. And now I'm just gonna create another circle. Hold Control plus shift, drag out, and I'm gonna add a black color. hold shift, click on the X to get rid of the fill. I'm gonna set the width and height into 10 pixels. Make sure to turn on the lock to turn on the proportions, to lock the proportions. I'm gonna turn on the snapping again, and just gonna snap it in the middle like this. Control plus D, like that. And now as you see, this two object is still in a stroke. So we need to convert it into a path. So go to the path, stroke to path. And I'm just gonna do something like this, select all of them, go to the path, union, to unify them together, like that. Alright, and now, the next thing they're gonna write now, we're gonna create another circle, like this. I'm gonna set the size into 25 by 25 pixels, hold shift and click on this, you know, smaller rounded square, and I'm gonna align it on the right as well as on the bottom, like that, and then we're gonna go to bezier curve tool. I'm gonna snap it over here, hold control and drag it to the right until it snaps again, and then I'm gonna arbitrarily like this, do something like this and back to its starting point, and make sure the object, the bezier curve that we have created, it's covering up the half portion of the circle. So hold shift and click on the circle again with the path difference, so we have something like this. And I'm just gonna select this thing again, control plus D to duplicate it, hold control and drag it to the right until it snaps like this. And then I'm gonna go to bezier curve tool again. I'm gonna do something like this. Snap it over here, over here, over here. Hold control and drag it up like this and back to its starting point. And I'm just gonna select this thing over here. And then I'm gonna raise it to the top. Hold shift. So raise it to the top. Like that. Hold shift and click on this object over here. Go to the path difference. So I don't know what happened there. Like that, path difference. So we have something like this. I'm gonna select both of them, go to the path union, and we have something like this. This looks like the foldable feature out of everything, of the calendar. And now it's time for us to do the coloring and then adding the text later. So I'm gonna select all of them, and then I'm gonna raise the opacity to 100%. And this biggest object, I'm gonna like give it a blue color as well as this one, and yeah, to differentiate it from everything. Now on this blue, like really blue object, I'm gonna set it into 30% gray, and on this fold, on this foldable object, I'm gonna make it like 20% gray, like that. And on this page, I'm gonna make it 10% gray, and then for the red color, I'm gonna make it a bit lighter. Like that. Alright, the color is done. It looks pretty except for this one. I'm gonna make it 80% gray. Yeah, looks awesome. Alright, now it's time for us to add in the text. By using the text tool, I'm gonna left clicking it until we have something highlight like this. I'm gonna type in August because it is Indonesian Independence Day. It's on August. And the font is Montserrat. And make sure it's on heavy style. I'm gonna make it like 10. So it's a bit wider like this. I'm gonna set it into white color and hold shift and click on the red object, and then I'm gonna align it vertically so it's perfectly in the middle, and then we're gonna left clicking on that to select it, hold control and drag it down like this. I'm gonna hold control and drag it down. I'm gonna make sure I turn off the snapping because it just get in the way. Hold control and drag it down like this. Yeah, I think it's looks so big. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Alright, now I'm gonna add in 17. Because Indonesian Independence is on 17 August 1945. Same thing, Montserrat heavy. I'm gonna set it into 80% gray and hold shift and click on this page. I'm gonna align it into vertical axis so it sits perfectly in the middle. I'm gonna make the spacing like 5. Yeah, 5 should look good. And I'm just gonna select it again, hold control and drag it downward. So yeah, like this. Hold control plus shift. And I'm gonna make this thing bigger. Around that size. That looks pretty good. Alright, our object calendar is done. So that's it, guys. That's how you create flat design calendar using Inkscape. Let me know what tutorial and video you want in the future. And as always, guys, thank you for your time.